Bună ziua, se apropie Brexitul și l-am rugat pe domnul ambasador Andrew Noble, ambasadorul Marii Britanii în România, să ne explice câteva chestiuni legate de ce îi așteaptă pe românii din Marea Britanie. Avem o comunitate mare acolo de peste 400.000 de persoane și evident ce ne așteaptă și pe noi în legătură cu relația cu Marea Britanie, firmele românești, firmele britanice, chestiuni legate de securitate, pentru că suntem parteneri cu Marea Britanie. Deci, haideți să vedem ce putem afla astăzi. Thank you, Your Excellency, for coming to Hot News, Dr. Rome. First question, the Prime Minister, Mr. Boris Johnson, has presented yesterday his new deal proposal to the EU. What are the main changes since the last three drafts that had been rejected by the British Parliament?
Well, can I first of all say it's very nice to be at Hot News. I rely on you every day, so it's good to be at your home. The key difference was how to replace what is called the backstop, which is a guarantee clause that would operate in 2021 if our negotiations have failed. And that had a certain number of components that were unacceptable, in particular that it was undemocratic, and it also had no means of the United Kingdom ever deciding to leave it. We did not have the possibility to leave it. So it's quite unusual in terms of international agreements that you lock in a country forever. And so the Prime Minister has presented a package of measures which does the same things as the backstop would have done, but in a way that is democratic and that preserves the possibility of coming out of it if that were ever a decision. But it preserves the substance of what the backstop was attempting to do.
Yes, but the opposition leaders in Britain already expressed their dismay about the new proposals. Many say that it doesn't reflect the Good Friday Agreement. It wouldn't bring stability in the Irish Island.
Well, as the Prime Minister said in his letter to President Juncker, the first objective is to preserve the Belfast Agreement and all of the benefits that that has brought to the whole island of Ireland. So that is our starting point. I would expect opposition spokesmen not to like it. That is what an opposition is for. I think the reaction that it's had from President Juncker and from other people is far more open-minded, and they have undertaken to look objectively at what is being proposed. I think for your audience, the key thing is that it preserves an island without a physical border. There will be no physical border between Ireland and Northern Ireland. That is the most important thing. It preserves Ireland as a single zone of free movement. It preserves Northern Ireland as Ireland as a single market with no regulatory differences between Northern Ireland and the South. The thing it does have as a difference is that Northern Ireland would not be in the customs union, but anything that is required to implement that customs regime can be done without ever needing any sort of physical border. Customs checks can be done in very different ways.
Yes, Your Excellency, but what about the Romanians living in the UK? We have a very large community there, over 400,000 people, maybe 500,000, according to the Romanian MFA, yes. But what's the impact of the new proposal for them, as well as for all the other EU citizens living in the UK?
Well, of course, the British government wants a deal. We're working hard for a deal. If there is a deal, on the 1st of November, nothing will change at all for all the EU citizens living in the UK. That's one of the reasons why it's worth every effort to to find a deal that the EU and the UK can accept and that would be acceptable to the British Parliament. If there were to be no deal, then we have put in place a series of measures which preserves the rights that EU citizens have in the UK. It is very easy to apply for, it is free, and it guarantees their rights. So far, about 1.4 million people have been successful in their registration, and approaching 200,000 Romanians have already applied.
Please explain to us, why is it so important for the EU citizens in the UK, including Romanians, to apply for a post-Brexit status?
It's technical. We will no longer be in the EU. Therefore, all of the provisions, all of the laws that were based on our membership of the EU no longer have validity in that way. So even the people who had permanent residence will need to apply for the new status. It is bureaucracy, the sort of bureaucracy that we all need to make life work. But that's one of the reasons why the government was so keen to make it a light, easy and free process so that people are not having to pay for it.
So it's a straightforward process. It's online. Everything is online.
Yes.
So there's no reason not to apply.
There's no reason not to apply at all. Everything is online. But of course, there are some people, vulnerable people, perhaps older people, who are not comfortable with online. And therefore, we've also funded a whole series of organisations and offices to help people with the applications. So anybody who's finding the actual application process difficult can easily find help. We're working in very close contact with all of the EU embassies. The Romanian embassy in London is very busy on this topic. And so people can either approach elements of the British government or the Romanian embassy or the consulates in the UK for help.
When is the deadline for applying? What happens if one, for example, misses the deadline?
Well, you'd have to work quite hard to miss the deadline, because on the assumption that if we were to leave with no deal on the 31st of October, people would have until the 31st of December to apply. That's the 31st of December 2020. So
one year.
There's another 14 months in which they can apply.
So what if one's application in the settlement scheme is rejected? What could he do about that? For what reasons, for example, could be rejected such an application?
Well, the most recent figures that I've seen, and they're about a month old. As I said, we have 1.4 million people who have registered successfully. We have had one person who failed. And that person failed because he was a serious criminal. Okay. And should never have been allowed into the country in the first place. Mm-hmm. This is a scheme that is designed for success. And that's been everybody's experience so far. I should say that there are some people who are dissatisfied that they only got pre-settled status rather than settled status.
Yeah.
That's something that can be looked at, but fundamentally, everybody is enjoying success when they apply.
Mm-hmm. Then, after the 5 years since the pre-settled status was granted, what kind of rights would the applicant have?
Well, once they've been in the UK for 5 years,
yeah.
They can then apply for settled status,
okay.
Which is the equivalent of permanent residence. And they then continue their lives in the UK as a permanent resident, mm-hmm. as now.
Yes, but they also can apply for citizenship?
They can apply for citizenship along the existing rules as we have now.
Mm-hmm.
So it was important to us that nothing should change. And I think that's what we've achieved.
Yes. Okay, so a Romanian gets the pre-settled or settled status. What about his family living in Romania, his parents, for example? How could they come to the UK to visit the actual person?
If we leave, we want a deal.
Yeah.
It's worth working hard for a deal, so nothing will change on the 1st of November. If we were to leave without a deal, Romanian citizens will be able to travel to the UK still using their ID document. That might change in the future, but at the moment they can travel with ID. If they travel with a passport, they can use the e-gates, which is the easiest way of passing the border. They can stay in the UK for up to 90 days. They do not need a visa. If they want to stay for longer than 90 days in a 180-day period, they can apply for leave to stay for up to 3 years. And that will all, that is all a very simple application process.
Yes. What would be the consequences of a no-deal Brexit? Because there is not much time left for a deal. And what happens with the Romanians in the UK in this no-deal scenario?
Well, we've made big efforts to ensure that functionally nothing unattractive happens to them. The Romanians living and working in the UK are very precious members of our society. They play an important role. They're extremely good workers. They seem to be happy there. We are very happy with them. And so we want to have no negative consequences at all. For the whole of the UK and for the whole of the EU, the economic consequences of no deal are clear. And they are negative. I don't think there's anything good about no deal. And that's why it's worth the Commission and Member States being determined to find the political will and the flexibility so that we can actually leave with a deal.
Yeah, it's clear that the Romanians in the UK need the jobs there, and the companies, the British companies, need the people to work for them, because this is why they hired them in the first place.
Yeah. You know?
And in the case of a no-deal scenario, what would be the consequences for the British companies that have Romanian workers, and for those who need more Romanian workers or EU citizens?
Yes.
Workers?
Well, at the moment, as you know, we've got historically low levels of unemployment. The level of job creation in the UK, despite the uncertainties that the last 3 years have created, has continued unabated. Our growth is strong, our prospects are strong. The prospects are less good with no deal, but we're starting off on a very good basis. Our innovation, our creativity, has meant that we have rebounded extremely effectively from the economic crisis in 2008 to generate a situation with almost full employment. We are confident that if it were to be a no-deal Brexit, those same impulses would create a rebound within the British economy. And functionally, the Romanian citizens who are living there should not be adversely affected. Indeed, they've demonstrated themselves to be amongst the best workers. So I would expect them to do very well, even in the circumstances of no deal.
What about the consequences of a no deal Brexit for the British people living in Romania, or for the mixed families living in Romania or in the UK?
Yeah. Well, the Romanian government has developed a package which has now been discussed at Cabinet for legislation very soon.
Yes, yesterday.
Exactly.
It was discussed in the government.
And we hope that that will be legislation sometime next week. The Romanian government has worked very closely with us on that. The spirit of reciprocity is what we've asked for. And I hope in the final package that we get, there will be that full reciprocity, including on important areas which have been preserved within the British offer of rights to healthcare, education and social services.
So have you discussed with the Romanian officials about these legislations? Are you in contact
We're in very close contact, yes.
Yes. So, and you are satisfied with the legislative process?
It's not for us to comment on the legislative process. On the contents of the package, I think there are some areas, the last version we saw, where I think we think there is more space for reciprocity. We think there's a big importance on ensuring that we have a reciprocal health agreement in place, so that the health provisions for Brits here and Romanians in the UK continues as they are at the moment. And the government has indicated to us that they are hopeful that that can be achieved as well. But that's probably still the biggest prize to be really confident about.
So basically, at the moment, you're not very happy with the provisions regarding health services for the British citizens living in Romania?
I think there are still some areas where the British offer is more is fuller, and therefore we hope that the Romanian government will be able to match it. And health is probably the most important area.
Mm-hmm. But what about the mixed families living in the UK? For example, there are Romanian women married to British men, or vice versa, in the UK. What do you think their status would be like in the scenario of no Brexit?
I don't think it will be different to pure Romanian couples, or a Romanian married to a Frenchman, or whatever. I think it sounds to me like a very happy multicultural household.
Great. Let's talk about business, Your Excellency. What happens to our companies and our trade in case of a no-deal Brexit? The UK wants a free trade agreement with the EU. We have a lot of trade between our countries and between your country and the whole European Union. There are a lot of uncertainties, like the border controls, the custom provisions, the custom process, the whole process. So what should the Romanian companies expect for, and what should the British companies expect for?
Forgive me if I say that your question again underlines why getting a deal is such a good idea. Because if nothing changed on the 1st of November, that would be great. We have recently held an all-day seminar with employers' organisations, Romanian companies, hauliers, and others, to explain what the new arrangements will be on the border, how to go about the customs processes, which can be made much easier if they are conducted earlier than when a lorry actually arrives at the border. We've explained to them that we will be, for the British side, prioritising flow over customs receipts. So it's much more important to us that the supplies going into the UK can be maintained, and that trade will continue in that way. So we're being very pragmatic about it. Obviously, there will be big changes if we were to leave without an orderly departure. But we are doing everything we can. We are fully prepared for that now. And any company in Romania or any individual is free to consult everything which is laid out on our government online site. I mean, gov.uk has got every answer available. We prioritise the delivery of online services, and in the embassy we also have somebody who's looking at that all of the time, so people can get in touch with us if they have questions that can't be answered by gov.uk.
Your Excellency, beyond the EU framework, Romania and the United Kingdom signed a strategic partnership. Do you think it should be updated after Brexit? To address the new situation and to optimize the bilateral cooperation?
I absolutely think it should be updated, and that's what we're doing. We're at a very advanced stage in discussions with Romanian government on that exactly that topic, and I hope that within a few weeks that we'll be able to sign it and launch the increased ambition that we have for that strategic partnership. But it will cover every area that you would imagine, starting with big topics like European security and Romania's and the UK's position within it and our cooperation, and go right to people-to-people links, which is such a strong component of our Romania-UK relationship.
Apart the large Romanian community in the UK, Romania is also very interested to keep a very good cooperation with the UK in the terms of security and defense. The UK has a strong army. It is one of the only two nuclear powers in the Western Europe, and a permanent member of the UN Security Council. So its strategic position is very strong in Europe. And the British contribution to the security in our region and in Romania in particular is highly appreciated. All these Brexit negotiations, this acid, aggressive debate in our societies and in media around Brexit, is there a risk to harm our future relationship in NATO and our political and military cooperation?
Well, I can only speak for the British government, obviously, and our intention is the opposite of harm. We have made absolutely clear from the outset that, A, we're staying in Europe. We're not, you know, we have no choice. We are part of Europe. We will be part of Europe, even if we leave one organisation. NATO is going to be of fundamental importance, as it is now. But we also want a very well-developed security relationship through the EU. The governments of Romania, together with Poland and Lithuania, called for that last year. And now committees of the French Parliament have called for that enhanced security relationship UK-EU after Brexit. That's very much something that we support and think is in the best interests, not only of the United Kingdom, but of citizens throughout the EU. But on top of that, our bilateral cooperation on all aspects of security, military as well as others, will remain very deep and very. There is a huge amount of confidence between the UK and Romania. Romania is one of our most important partners, and that will continue as long as we both face serious threats to our security and to our citizens' security. I think that that unity of purpose and that readiness to cooperate will continue. So I'm absolutely convinced in whatever forum that UK-Romania security cooperation will remain at the height of the top quality that it is today.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for your answers. If you have a final word, a final message for the Romanian community living in the UK and for the British community living in Romania?
Well, to Romanians in the UK, I would just say what a very important part of our country you are. And we want you to stay there, we want you to feel happy. Please apply for settled or pre-settled status as early as you can. Show the others how to do it. To the Brits in Romania, I would say thank you for being as patient as you have been. I hope we will soon be in a position to know what the Romanian offer is definitively when it's published, hopefully next week. And we will then look forward to talking to you about any questions that you might have.
Thank you, Your Excellency.
Thank you very much.